गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. आई थिंक विद इन हाफ ए मिनट आई कैन जस्ट से थैंक यू आवेश. टू बी वेरी प्रिसाइज आई जस्ट कवर द कंज्यूमर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इट. सो टू बिगिन विद आई एम कवरिंग द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ कंज्यूमर्स एंड विल दे बेनिफिट द कंज्यूमर्स. सिंस द मॉर्निंग वी हैव कवर्ड द सेपरेशन ऑफ कैरेज, द ओपन एक्सेस, एंड आई थिंक वी हैव कवर्ड द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ all those things over on the consumers. We have covered that how the low end consumers are not get benefited by the open access and other things. But there are a few other things which is there in the act which we have not mentioned during the day in the conference, and I would like to bring your attention to those sections. And I quote section 94 clause 3 that says the appropriate commission may authorize any commission at it deemed fit to represent the interest of consumer in the proceedings before it. And the amendment bill has changed this may to the shall. This is one of the major change this amendment bill is bringing for the consumer benefit. With this change, the consumer will get a sure-shot representation in the commission. So consumer, this is not going to be the low end consumer, this can be any consumer, everyone is a consumer. So he will get the representation in the commission. But as we have seen in the we have noticed in the morning that minister mentioned that, you know, that we have like this bill has not discussed properly, so he want this to be discussed thoroughly before this passed in the parliament. So obviously we also want this to be discussed thoroughly before this get passed in the parliament. But this type of representation in the commission also give boost to the consumers. The second point I want to mention is the compliance with CGRF. There are also few points which this bill has mentioned. There is a provision related to CGRF and ombudsman, which gives power to the CGRF ombudsman to judge the proceedings of the things. So basically whenever the CGRF and ombudsman give any order for the consumers and utility goes to the court, there is always whenever utility get the order, and it always says that whenever it get the favor of the consumers and it goes to the high court or whichever court goes to, the utility says that this is in the court, so we are not giving the whatever amount is due to the consumers. So there is a provision which says that 148 and 146 which says that punishment for non-compliance of direction and appropriate commission. So under this bill, the government could have made it compulsory for the utilities to compliance with the order of the CGRF or ombudsman, which they didn't. So this could have been a miss by this bill.
Hold on, Gaurav. Point man, please make a note that the issue of ombudsman and the other thing, CGR. That CGR, consumer grievance redressal forum or whatever, needs to be put in. There should be a much more aggressive direction in that, because of the fact that utilities are delaying issues. Yep.
Right. So this can be a justice delayed, which is justice denied, because most of the time what happened is that when you go to the court and the high court don't stay that order particular given by the CGRF and ombudsman, utility take that as a thing against you and says that this is before the court, so we are not complying with the order given by CGR ombudsman, and the person has to go under section 142 and 146, which again prolongs.
Write this down as well. Once the order is given by the consumer grievance cell, then again it's not complied by the utility. Okay.
148, sure. 146.
So you need to strengthen that section, which gives the powers to the consumer grievance cell I don't know how you're going to do that, but we need to find a way out.
Right. So there's a need to strengthen that. Other than this, there is again a need of consumer fund, because being a consumer organization, what we have noticed is that there is a need of awareness within the consumers about the laws, the awareness about the procedures, the proceedings of the courts, and the regulatory aspects, regulatory mechanism. So there should be some fund where CSOs can be strengthened. Now there is a particular particular provision which talk about the consumer representation also. So if there is...
No, Gaurav, I'm not clear. What exactly are you saying? You want a fund?
I'm talking about a fund, right?
To do what?
To strengthen the consumer activities, because there is a provision which talks about
representation. No, understood. So you want to basically have funds to strengthen consumer activity. What you want to
awareness?
Okay, so education of the consumer.
Education, awareness.
Okay, awareness campaign.
And you're talking about.
I think very important point, and the government will take this down very well. That we need to spend money and provide money and budgets for educating the consumer that there is such a forum, and if you have a problem, come to us. Fair right. Point. Next point, please.
Right. So I think these are the three basic points I want to make. And rest we have discussed during the day.
Okay.
And with this, I want to conclude with the saying that there is the further consultation required for the bill. Thank you.
Sorry, repeat the last sentence. What?
There is a further consultation required before we pass the bill.
Excellent. So.